no bosses. You don't know me, so that speak for itself. Catch up before your ass get left. When you see the raw hat, when you looking at the teeth, only worm get the worm, nigga. Money don't sleep.
I go.
Back with another video. Okay, so in this video, taking this dash back out, and I'm about to take these vents out because I bought all new vents. Take them vents out. The only ones that I didn't get but that was in good shape is that one right there, and then the one that goes at the bottom of the dash. Other than that, I got the two that goes up here, and then the one that goes right there, and then that one right there. So I'm about to take this dash out. I'm gonna sand down this metal and spray it with undercoating, and then I'm doing away with this cigarette lighter. So throwing that out. What else? I gotta tape up the glove box lock, even though I don't have the key to it, but whatever. And then I fixed a little crack right here, as y'all can see. Fixed a little crack right there, and then I'ma put some more glue on the back side of it, and probably hit it with some more because it might crack back. I don't know, but yeah, I'ma put some more glue on the back side of it. I'ma fill it with glue on the back side of it, and then hopefully once I sand it down and get this thing painted, this thing don't crack back when I'm putting it in here. But I gotta remind myself to buy this switch because I didn't get that switch. So that's something else on my roster. It's crazy that I'm still buying fucking parts. Had to get some sun visors, inserts, because the cardboard in them or the wood in them was all deteriorated. So I had to buy them. What else did I have to get? I had to get pieces for the AC unit. And then with this is where right here is where the original stereo went or goes. I'm going to make a plate and put a plate on the back side of that. I don't know. I might get that motherfucker engraved and put pressure in it. I don't know yet. Probably put a billet piece in there. But I don't know yet. But shit. Let me see. What else? That's pretty much it. I just need to get this dash out and then grind down this metal and then spray it. And then I think I'm gonna hit this thing with some water and clean it up real good because this motherfucker fucked up. Oh yeah, I also gotta get that relay that's in the back right there. Let me see if I can zoom in. Yeah, that relay right there, that's the blower motor relay. So some of them plugs that I didn't know what they went to, it all made sense once I got the dash back because all the plug-ins is on the back of this. So and then I got new parts and stuff for the box, like that grill and some other stuff. So man, let's go ahead and get this thing out. Put everything in the car that I'm gonna need tomorrow because I'm painting this thing tomorrow. Same color as the car. And of course I'm gonna show video on that. So this is gonna be part of that video. So this is pretty much gonna be, I think I'm gonna record the whole video. I ain't gonna make a part one and part two, but this is what I'm doing right now. So let's go ahead and get this dash out. Okay, YouTube, so I got the dash out. As you can see, that's where I made my little blend back. But it seemed like that motherfucker, actually it's pretty solid. I think I'm gonna put some, I might throw some Duraglass on it and just kind of But I really don't even want to do that because this dash got texture to it. So, I don't know. It'll be all right. I'm gonna put some more glue on it. Put some more glue on the backside. But as you can see, I'm about to scuff this stuff up, and then I'm gonna undercoat this, probably the whole bottom of this thing. I'm gonna undercoat the whole bottom of it. And I gotta clean out the glove box. Glove box got papers and stuff on it. So I'm gonna clean this thing up real good, cause I don't wanna be having no damn dirt blowing off on it when I'm painting it tomorrow. But for the most part, and then I gotta figure out, okay, that goes to that's the emergency brake. I'm not really worried about that right now. But yeah, I gotta get this switch out. I think, trying to figure this thing old as hell. Trying to figure out how to get this off. Look like it just snapped down in there. And then I can't forget, I got this ground on there. So I might have to put that back on there with the new one if the new one don't come with it. And then, but pretty much, light for the inside of the glove box. I'm taking this out. That's the ashtray. I need to get one of these. But I'm gonna leave that there just for reference. And then take this cigarette lighter out, because that's coming out. And then I can just scuff this boy down. Oh, I gotta take my vents out. But I'm gonna work on this backside first. And then I'm gonna let it dry, and then I'll come with the backside on whatever I gotta do to get the rest of that shit out. But yeah, that's what we dealing with right now. Motherfucker should look good when it get done getting painted. So yeah, let's go ahead and get it, scuff this shit up, get that rusting shit off, and let's put some Rust-Oleo on it. Okay, YouTube. I'm having a hard time getting these vents out, but as y'all can see, I coated all the rust with Rust-Oleum, and that's pretty much gonna be good. And I just need to figure out the best way to get them vents out. But other than that, as y'all can see, the fucking dash cracked again. So I'm gonna probably just go ahead and put some damn Gorilla Glue on it, and then just shape it up once it forms up. That was Gorilla Glue, but that was the clear shit. But of course I did sit it the wrong way. But I'll put some Gorilla Glue on it, and then I'll shape it up tomorrow once it harden up. But as you can see, I had to fill like some little holes. I don't know why they had in the dash, but once that harden up, I'll scuff that up with a Scotch-Brite and probably wet sander with like some 300. But I mean, the dash shit's like this anyway, so of course you ain't gonna be able to see it, but I'ma still do it anyways. But yeah, pretty much all I gotta do is mask that up and take these vents out. I'ma see if I can take this one out too, cause I really don't wanna paint it. And of course I gotta get that other piece. Make sure I don't forget this piece. Make sure I don't forget this piece. And then I'm gonna try to see if I can get this vent out too. They make it hard as a motherfucker to get these vents out. But I don't wanna paint that vent no either. This one or the other one. But I'ma scuff that one up, and then Once this shit harden up, then I'll scuff that down. That shit look bad, but it's gonna be up under the dash, so I ain't too worried about it. But then I'm gonna hit that backside with some Rust-Oleum. This gonna be up under the bottom side too, but I think I might put some fiberglass down there just to shape that back up. But other than that. And we get into it. So, but I'm gonna research these vents, and then I'll cut y'all back on once I get done. I still gotta take this out. Cause I gotta see how to get this out too. But I think that's screw out, but I'm not for sure. But I don't know. I'll figure it out. So I'll cut y'all back on once I get done. Okay, YouTube. So I got the vents out. I just went ahead and took the whole thing out because you gotta pretty much take them apart. Let me show y'all real quick. On these, when I was tearing these things up on the inside, but you actually gotta fucking take them apart to get them out. And I didn't even know that. I'm sitting here trying to get them out. They wasn't even gonna come out this way. So I just went ahead and took them out. I'm gonna keep this black, that black. I'm gonna paint this. And then I'll keep the sides of these black too. And this thing pretty much ready to go. I just gotta pretty much sand this fiberglass down. Did some fiberglass right there, and then did some plastic, put some of that shit back together with melting some plastic so that that shit wouldn't crack no more, because I can't afford to paint this thing and then it end up cracking. But the last thing I am gonna do here is sit that down, is I'm gonna make a little piece. I'm gonna make a little piece real quick, a little template that I can go buy. I don't know if I'm gonna do it with some cardboard, but then I'll probably do it with like probably either this, or I'll probably do some plexi. I don't know. But I am gonna cover that up. I'm gonna cover all that up. So I just get a piece to sit down in there real nice, and then I'll be good to go. But other than that, I'm gonna sand that down. These is just about dry. Scuff them down, blend everything in, and primer the shit out this motherfucker. I'm gonna use some, probably some 2K primer, but I'll show y'all that tomorrow. I'll use some 2K primer, fucking primer the shit out this motherfucker. And I think I got some Bulldog, some contact adhesive. I'm gonna need that, but pretty much getting this thing ready to paint. And you know we're gonna be getting down tomorrow, so just stay tuned for that. But for the most part, this thing is pretty much ready, prepped, just waiting till this harden up some more. I put a lot of hardener in it, so it should harden up pretty good. I'm gonna leave it caked up in the back just to keep it steady, but I'm gonna smooth out the front. And then I guess I'll cut y'all back on once I get done smoothing and sanding everything out. I'll cut y'all back on. Okay, YouTube, so I'm pretty much done. Done prepping. So basically what I did was I fixed the crack. And then I fixed the little holes that you seen. And then I basically fiberglassed it. Did the body work on it, and then I hit it with some texture, because you know this has got like a leather or a vinyl texture on it, but it's hard plastic. So I would just pretty much just hit it with like a texture spray to blend everything in, and then now it's ready and it's ready to prep. And I mean, well, it's ready to be painted. So basically what I'll do tomorrow is I'll go in, I'll blow it off real good, then I'll shoot it with some 2K primer. I'm gonna shoot it with some 2K primer, then I'm gonna let it sit, and then I'm gonna hit it with my base coat, custom pearl, and then my clear. So this is what we got right now. So take a good look. And I tested my Dakota Digital. Shout out to Steve Davis. I got that from him a long time ago. But I just wanted to make sure that motherfucker fit in there. That bitch looked nice in there. So once I get done with this dash, I'll do all of my duct work, which I'm getting ahead of myself, but this is just the plan. Do all my duct work and then go ahead and put my dash back in there, lay everything out, put my Dakota Digital in there, get everything lined up with my sensors, and make sure all of my lights and shit is working. Everything on that
that cluster. And then, man, we're pretty much gonna be good to go. So I'm gonna wait until this dry. So when it's time for, I'm gonna let it dry. And then before it dry up, which it ain't, it's almost dry now. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make that template. And then I'll probably wrap that in probably like the color of the car or suede or something like that. I ain't gonna put no name or nothing in there because it's just too time consuming. I don't really wanna do it anyways. But yeah, this is what we got. And I fixed that crack. And shit, I think I'm gonna make this part one. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna make it part one and part two. So part two will be tomorrow, but it's all prepped and ready to be painted. And I'm out. Okay, YouTube, I'm back real quick. I just wanted to show y'all this piece. So I got that piece sitting in there real nice, and then I did a round over on it. But I don't know. I don't think I'm gonna put nothing right there. Nah, I'ma just put it a different color. It's just pretty much just a block off plate, bro. But yeah, that's all I pretty much wanted to show y'all. And it's gonna be nice with incorporating it with the I think I'm gonna do with the color of the interior as opposed to the suede. But we'll see. But there we go. I'm out.